Hello friends, today we are going to solve CBSE class 10th mathematics exercise 1.1 question number 4. Use Euclid's division lemma to show that the square of any positive integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for some integer m. So what we have to do, look here, 3m or 3m plus 1. So we come to know that our divisor or our b will be 3. So first we will suppose positive odd integer, positive integer is equal to a. So by Euclid's division lemma, we get a is equal to 3q plus r, and if we are dividing with 3, so what can be our possible r, where r can be equal to 0 1 and 2. Why 3 is there? So less than 3 and 0 or greater than 0 and less than 3, so 0 1 2, we are dividing with 3. So now what can be our possible a? A can be equal to 3q plus 0, or A can be equal to 3q plus 1, or A can be equal to 3q plus 2. These are the possible answer. But we don't want A, we want square of any positive integer. So now we are going to do square of this, all the three numbers one by one, by taking one different cases. First we will take case number 1. That is a is equal to 3q. Now squaring both the side, that you have to write, I am directly doing it, squaring both the side. So a square will be equal to 9q square. We want this 3m, we want m. You can see in the question, we want 3m or 3m plus 1. So we want 3. So we are going to take out 3 common from this. So 3 common and the remaining, that is 3q square. Now a square will be our dividend, this is our divisor, and this will be our quotient over. So you have to write where 3q square will be equal to m. This you have to write in bracket, but right now generally students, why I had taken this as m, they are asking me. A square is equal to 3m, and they are asking me why I had taken it as m. Actually they told that this is the second part, second integer. This was our first division. Now during squaring we are getting our new, so this whole is our quotient. They are not giving us directly the quotient. Instead of that quotient, again they changed the number. It was q, now they had given us m. So m is our second time division's quotient. That will be m. Again I am doing it so that you will come in the next part more clearly. A is equal to 3q plus 1, again squaring both the side. So a square will be, now this is the identity that we have to use, a plus b whole square, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So we are going to use it directly, 9q square plus 6q plus 1. Now we have to take out common from these two, and that also 3 only we have to take out common. 3q square plus 2q is equal, plus 1, and this is a square. Now look here, again you can see this was our divisor, dividend, this was our divisor, and this is, this whole is our quotient, and this is our remainder. Now instead of this quotient, we are going to give this quotient name m. So you have to write where 3q square plus 2q is equal to m, that we have to suppose, because this is our quotient and we had given name to that whole quotient as m. A square is equal to 3m plus 1. This is our second answer. Now again case 3. A is equal to 3q plus 2, again squaring both the sides, so Again, identity number 1, a plus b whole square gives you a square plus 2ab plus b square. So here 9q square plus 3 to the 6 to the 12q plus 4. Now the problem arises here. When we are dividing something with 3, 4 cannot be our remainder. So what we are going to split it. How? 9q square plus 12q plus 3 plus 1. Because we know if we are going to divide any number with 3, the remainder should be less than 3. But here it is greater. Again, we can divide it. So I had split it into 3 plus 1. Now we are going to take out 3 common from this. 3 common. So 3q square plus 4q plus 1. And out of bracket also 1. Now we are going to take this as m, where you have to write where 3q square plus 4q plus 1 is equal to m. So again it will be a square is equal to 3m plus 1. Look here also 3m plus 1, here also it's 3m plus 1, here it's 3m. So our question was to prove that it is in the form of 3m and 3m plus 1. So 1 times 3m and 2 times 3m plus 1. So this way we can prove this sum. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you like it, please subscribe to my channel so that I can bring more such videos for you. Thank you so much.